Should I do my master's in computer science or data science? That's the confusion many of us have, and in this video I'm going to provide my honest opinion. Let's say you're planning to do your master's from foreign country, let's say USA, and now you're thinking, should I go for straight data science master or computer science with some AI subjects? Here in US, after finishing your master's, it takes like around 2 years, you will have to file for your H-1B, your work visa. You get 3-year OPT, but after that, yeah, you need a work visa. Now, in terms of number of jobs available, as of 2021, still, the number of jobs in computer science are way more than data science. If there are 10 software engineer positions, you will find only one computer scientist, data scientist position. So, in terms of getting the job, if you have computer science masters, your possibility of getting a job is higher because the job number of jobs are more. Now, once you do computer science with AI specialization, you can work as a computer engineer as well as a data scientist. It's not like to become data scientist, you have to do masters in data science. There are many computer science background graduates who have become data scientists. The benefit of doing data science master is that your whole focus during your entire study is data science. So if there is a specific data science job, then you will likely get an interview call. But the number of jobs for data scientists as of 2021 are less compared to computer engineer. So you have to keep these factors in my mind. After masters, most of the people have this criteria that they want to do job, they want to earn some money, you know, cover their tuition costs. So if you're not sure, I would advise computer science with AI specialization. Now, if you're doing studies without this visa consideration, for example, if you're doing studies in India or in your home country, then you don't have to worry about all these factors. Then do whatever you want to do, okay? So you have to look at the overall situation, like what is your criteria, like do you have to face visa situation and so on. And based on that, make a decision. If you have any question, post in a video comment below. I hope this short video helped you with some of your questions. Thank you.